You might be able to bypass TPM and secure boot, but there's one CPU feature just can't fake. And without it, Windows 11 version 24, H2 or newer simply won't install. It's called pop count. In this video, we'll show you what it is, why it matters, and how to check if your CPU supports it. Hey everyone, welcome back to the CNATD channel. We've already covered how to upgrade Windows 10 or 11 to 24H2 on both supported and unsupported systems. But there's one thing even the best bypass tools can't get around: your CPU instruction set. Starting with Windows 11 version 24H2, Microsoft now requires a specific instruction called pop count. And if your processor doesn't have it, the upgrade will fail, no matter what trick you try. So let's break down what pop count actually is and how you can check if your CPU supports it. What is pop count? Pop count stands for population count instruction. It's a low-level CPU feature that counts the number of bits set to one in a binary number. Sounds technical, but there's the bottom line. This instruction helps Windows 11 run efficiently, and Microsoft has made it a mandatory requirement for version 24H2. Without pop count, your CPU simply won't meet the baseline needed to boot or install this version of Windows, even if you bypass secure boot, TPM, RAM, or other checks. Intel versus AMD requirements. Pop count is typically bundled inside larger instruction sets. For Intel processors, that's SSE 4.2. For AMD processors, it's SSE 4A. These instructions actually date back to the mid-2000s. AMD started shipping pop count or ABM in 2006 with its Barcelona family CPUs. Intel followed in 2008 with Nehalem-based processors, adding pop count as a part of SSE 4.2. If your processor predates those architectures, think AMD Turin 2, Intel Core 2 Duo, or anything older, you won't have the pop count instruction. Although you may still run Windows 10 or Windows 11 version 23, H2 and earlier via bypasses, Windows 11 version 24, H2 or newer will flatly refuse to boot since it strictly requires pop count support with no workaround. How to check if your CPU supports pop count? There are several ways to check if your CPU supports pop count. The easiest method we suggest is to ask an artificial intelligence AI tool such as OpenAI's ChatGPT, Microsoft Copilot, Google Gemini, or another AI service. For example, we asked ChatGPT the following question: does my Intel Core i3-3632QM CPU support PopCNT? We've included this example question in the description. Simply replace the CPU model with yours and ask the AI. As you can see, our old laptop CPU supports this capability. Another way to check if your CPU supports pop count is by using CPU-Z, a popular and widely recognized third-party tool. Download CPU-Z from the official CPU ID website. The download link can be found in the description. After installation, open CPU-Z. Go to the CPU tab and look for the instructions section. If your computer's CPU is Intel, check if SSE 4.2 is listed among the supported instruction sets. If your computer's CPU is AMD, check if SSE 4A is listed among the supported instruction sets. If it's listed, you're safe to upgrade to Windows 11 version 24H2 or newer. If not, you'll be limited to version 23H2 or lower. Why this matters? Many people think bypassing Microsoft's check is enough, but the pop count requirement proves that's not always the case. You can disable TPM checks, skip secure boot, even bypass RAM and CPU generation warnings, but you can't bypass hardware-level CPU instructions. So before you waste time trying to force install Windows 11 24H2 or newer, check for pop count support first. It could save you hours of frustration and maybe even your sanity. If this helps you understand pop count and whether your CPU is compatible with Windows 11 24H2 or newer, give it a like and feel free to share your thoughts in the comments. And if you're curious how to install Windows 11 version 24H2 on unsupported PCs that do meet this requirement, we've already shown you how to bypass the restrictions in the previous videos. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.